Hey guys, you know that the first thing that a malware does once it is deployed on the target machine is to gain persistence. In this video, we're going to see how can we investigate in order to check if there is a potential persistence mechanism on the Windows workstation. To start our investigation, first we need to have the logs. So then to do the logs collection, we're going to use Kanza, which is a PowerShell tool that can be used to collect logs from Windows workstation remotely. Let me just show you the command line. It's like you need to use the Kanza script and give it a path modular, the target machine where we will collect the logs and credential and a authentication type. I'm already on the Kanza folder. As you can see on modules, we have different scripts that can be used to collect logs from RISIS, for example. We have script to collect logs related to memory and so on. But for this demonstration, we're going to use three scripts, the auto runs, the persistence file and register keys, and the get scheduler task. Let me just open my PowerShell to show you how can we use it. By the way, it will take a little bit of time. Let me just speed up a little bit and come back when I will have our logs collected. Alright, now that we do have our logs, let's just start our hunting, looking for suspicious information on our logs that we already collected. To do that, we're gonna use the Timeline Explorer, a Zimmerman tool, by the way, very useful to analyze some CSV files. I have this one first, let me just grab it and open here, right? Let me go ahead and take the second one. And the last one, but not this one, sorry, will be, schedule task, already have schedule task, not yet, okay. All right, so let's start applying some filter in order to check if there is a potential suspicious binary that has been used to add persistence on this on the workstation where we collect the logs, right? I'll start by here, you know, on the scheduled task. Maybe I'll go filter by the task name because there is a lot of tasks, for example, related to the Brave software. I can tell that it is legitimate. I have this one, Google Startup. It is interesting. Let me just filter and do a closer look on. Okay, it has been created. I have this binary, google.exe, which is weird. The location first thing first. Okay, we'll just keep an eye on it, you know, and check if I can see other suspicious tasks. Google start, I have related to Microsoft, okay. And check this one, I'll say Microsoft. No, it's the .NET framework. Yeah, nothing suspicious to tell. This one, check also to see if there is something suspicious. Windows, not suspicious. Okay, I will keep this one, you know, up. Be honest. I'll keep my Google start over here and move on to see if I can find some other suspicious on others logs. I have the Google startup, you know, just keep in mind, we do find this binary. Let's go on the persistence files and register keys. We don't have a lot of logs, to be honest. Check, okay, looks like legit binaries over here. Let's go on the auto start. The auto start, I like start by filter by the binaries that are not signed, for example, you know, it's kind of good. Just take that. Okay. And interesting, because I just filter it and I have again our suspicious binary. So it is better like to do a close look on this binary to see where it comes from and if it has been executed. Check also the hash to see if it is known as malicious or not. And if you know how to program, you can just do a script in order to automate your task. For example, I did this Python script that kinda helped me to analyze very quickly the out of ROM's logs. Let me just explain the script to you. First, I will open the file. After that, I will put some data into a dictionary. For example, the colon entry location, designer category, image path. And what I will do next, will like print a summary about the others binary that are present on my log file. And after that, I will just loop on it and check if there is a binary that is not verified or it is not signed. And after that, I will just print it. Let me just go ahead and run it. So then you can see the result is Python tag NSI. All right, as you can see, I find my binary is over here very quickly, by the way. And I kind of have a summary over here that tells me about other files that also are on my log. And if I want, I can just modify it to go deeper to check more about others binary. All right, guys, let me just show you this another tool that I use in order to investigate to see if there is a potential suspicious file on my CSV logs. So, but how does it work? It will compare a baseline logs with a new logs. So then it will check to see if there is a new value or a value that has been changed. Let me just show you how does it works. I will open that. I have the baseline of my autoruns first over here. I will open it. I need to give it a unique key value. For this one, I will give hash, right? I'll go on path, go signer. I do process date and I come here. Now I can give to it my logs, right? Is here. Now, as you can see, we did find our suspicious google.exe. We just go ahead and do the same with another logs. Up this one. I'll do path, I'll do value, right? To process it. And for the regis key, let me just find it. It's the second one, right? Can read it. Okay, we have detected new entry detected. Could be better to investigate, better to see if we can find something suspicious, right? Just go ahead and check for the last one. Will be the schedule task. The unique key would be, I will give it the task name. And I will give the task executor to that. Come here, the same last one. We'll check to see if we can find our suspicious Google. All right, so guys, I do have this another tool that I also can use to investigate potential persistence mechanism on Windows workstation. Let me just go ahead and show you how does it work. It has a lot of different tools. I will use Persistence Sniper, which is a great one. I like this tool, by the way. I need to start by selecting target is this one. And then from here, I can just check whatever technique I want to check. For example, I'll go by Explorer load, I will run it. It will take a little bit of time. It will come. Okay, finish. You can see there is no persistence mechanism found. I can go ahead, you know, and choose another technique. For example, this one. It will come. Okay, finish. You can see we did find our Google suspicious binary. Let me check this one also. Again, we did find it. So thanks for watching me, guys. I'm going to put the link of my tools on the description of the video so then you can download for free and use it. See you on the next video and be safe on the internet.